If you're focusing on the negative things in life, the things that bring us down, you get this idea of paranoid, the idea that you're separate from the universe, that everyone's out to get me. You know, I'm separate and I have to protect myself. I have to build walls. People want to rob me. People want to take advantage of me. People want to hurt me. People want my stuff. You know, they're out to get me. It's based on fear and separation. I'm scared that the people are going to get me and I have to separate myself and build walls and protect. That's the default mode for a lot of people in the world. Most wars, most conflicts are caused by this fear and separation. And people haven't actually, many people, it hasn't occurred to them that you can have the opposite. You can have pronoia, the belief that the universe is plotting to make you happy and that there's nothing you can do about it. And that's based on love and connection. And if you think about it, if you are the universe, if the universe is in you, the universe is plotting to make you happy. There's no separation. And no matter what you do, no matter what circumstances come to your life, no matter how seemingly bad those circumstances are, they're actually there to make you happy. And there's nothing you can do about it. Now, I mean, I live in this state. I mean, I cultivate it. And you can actually actively cultivate it. But I also tell you that it's delusional. Both pronoia and paranoia are delusional. And often I talk about, I have a mental health condition. And it's incurable. And it's progressive. And it may be contagious. So I'm warning you here. And it's called pronoia. But as I say, it's delusional. Paranoia is delusional. Because the truth is, the universe is not out to help you. And the universe is not out to hurt you. The universe just is. But here's the key. If you're going to be deluded, you can choose your delusion. Exactly. Consciously choose your delusion. And that's where the power of consciousness comes in. You actually have the power to buy into paranoia or pronoia. If you're going to think, if you're going to engage in the world of thinking, and I must say thinking is overrated. You know, you don't need to think to actually have a beautiful life. And in fact, most of the beautiful moments in our lives are when we're not thinking, when we're in this expanded state of being totally in the moment. And if you're going to think, you can then, when you get out of being in the thought, into the depression, in the anger, in the whatever the emotion, if it's an unpleasant emotion, if you step out of that, you can say, oh, that was interesting, that was an unpleasant emotion. There's a gift in that for me, because for any unpleasant emotion, there's an equally valid pleasant one. Now, babies, that's Marley, my son, is now 11. But babies naturally have pronoia. I mean, if you think of about a baby, the whole universe is there to feed them, to bathe them, to toilet them, to entertain them, and to love them. You know, pronoia is our natural state. Life is that balance. You've got capacity, you've got challenges. You've got giving, you've got receiving. And when we find the sweet spot between that, we have this concept of flow, of being at one, of being really happy. Although happiness implies you're sort of thinking about it. This idea of in flow and being joyful, self-forgetful movement of the body, of the mind, it's beyond thought. And this idea of giving back to the universe, to develop an attitude of gratitude. It says in daily life we must see that it is not happiness that makes us grateful, but gratefulness that makes us happy. When we're being grateful, we're looking up at the balloons and we're saying thank you. We're looking up. We're looking at all the blissfuls in our life. We're looking at all the good things. When we're complaining, we're looking down at the weights. So, well, look at that. That's hassle there. Oh, look at that problem there. Look at that problem there. It's up to us to choose where to look. But if we look down all the time, we're complaining all the time, suddenly our neck and our posture becomes looking down all the time. We forget to look up. So in giving thanks and being grateful, every meal, every breath, we develop this attitude of looking up, or at least looking straight ahead. So we need to balance between looking down. I mean, it's good to look down occasionally. You don't want to fall down the cliff. But, you know, you want to balance that by looking up and keep your whole posture in life balanced. And the more you can balance receiving with giving, and no matter where you're at, no matter what's happened to you, there's something to be grateful for. Again, it's your choice. But this idea of gratitude, that you're exercising your choice to give thanks and to look up and appreciate what you've got, and that'll make you happy. Now, leading a balanced life is simple. Share your feelings, eat good food, exercise, relax, and just be. It's a good life pyramid. You have the good food pyramid? There's a good life pyramid. Sharing your feelings is the main one. Remember, being connected? Currency of wellness is connection. If you share your feelings, that is the underpinning of a good life. Eat good food, important. Exercise, very important. Relax, but then just spending time just to be. Just to be in that point of stillness. Connecting with nature is one of the most powerful things we can do. There's a whole lot of research on happiness, wellness, and the connection with nature. And it's totally, I say, the positive effects on human health, particularly in urban environments, cannot be overestimated. You cannot, the research, and this is a review, it was actually fostered by Parks Victoria, and there's now a second Healthy Parks, Healthy People conference. The first one was a couple of years ago, and they had 1,200 people at the convention centre here talking about the connection between health and nature, and it's so profound. Bringing nature into your environment, you know, plants into your house, spending time in a garden, spending time at the beach with a natural border, taking your shoes off and grounding yourself in the earth. The more you can connect with nature, that's certainly one of those bubbles, those balloons that you can really cultivate. Eating slow food, seasonal, local, organic and whole. If you're going to eat junk food, really enjoy it. Like, really enjoy it. Don't just sort of eat it while you're doing other stuff and it's just a matter of course, you know. Your body is a temple, you know, respect it and value it. And the greatest joys in life come from our connection with people rather than possessions, places or pills. So if you want to be happy, cultivate the connection you have with other people. Sharing your feelings, connecting with people. And really protect what's in your consciousness. It's really valuable. And it's valuable to me because your happiness actually influences my happiness. So thank you for your attention. Thank you.